Yeah. Hi, Anthony here at WPPI 2016 conference, and I'm talking to Larry Kaufman of Epson, and he's going to give us an overview of Epson, some of the history of it, and of course any new product on hand. So welcome, Larry.
Thank you. Thank you, Anthony.
Great. Tell us about the history of Epson. I know Epson is a big name in printing, and a lot of photographers, of course, prefer Epson products.
Right. Epson, one of our core competencies, one of the things that we do, is the micropiezo printhead itself. So it's the mechanism by which we're dropping ink onto the printed page, and it what gives us our amazing print quality and print speed. But something people may not know is we actually have a great staff of chemists. So people that develop our ink technology and our pigment technology and basically move the state of the art of a print, how long it's going to last, how it looks, how it's treated under different lighting, all those type of things is all part of the Epson brand as well.
Okay. And how old is Epson brand, by the way?
Epson historically goes back through multiple generations. I can kind of speak to 1999 when I joined Epson. That was the launch of the first 44-inch wide format printer in the photo space with a Stylus Pro 9000. But the concept of Epson equals photo kind of in the late 1990s and early 2000s, as we saw this shift from traditional silver halide photography to digital, is where Epson really, kind of gained our name.
Right.
We wanted to push, the digital print forward.
Right, and we're standing in front of a large format printer here, so can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, this is the new Surecolor P10000. This is our state-of-the-art printer. Whoop, I think I was leaning on something there. This is state-of-the-art. So this is a 44-inch wide production printer. I don't know if this will come through on video, but this would be a nozzle check off of our standard 44-inch printer. Okay, so it's a 1-inch wide print head, 360 nozzles. This is the nozzle check off of our new print head. Okay, in this unit, so 8,000 nozzles, and that equates to speed. So it's the new printer introductions. Basically, we're trying to push the boundaries of outputting amazing quality at speeds that had not been seen before. And the beautiful thing is all the technology that we develop here is available to users, down into the 13-inch segment. So the print quality, what comes out of the printer may take it a little bit longer, but all the ink technology and all that basically is delivered across our class of products.
All right, a couple of questions, Larry. Let's say a portrait photographer, wedding photographer is looking to use this particular machine for black and white. How would that come out?
We have a beautiful advanced black and white driver mode. We have multiple black technology in our printers, so it's one of the things that actually works really well for us. With the light black and light black inks, and then the ability to use light colored inks to give the black and white tonality if you want to go a little bit sepia or want to give it a little bit cooler. Our standard driver technology for Mac or PC gives the user full control over that.
And this particular model right here would be good for people who do maybe signs?
This particular model with the P10000 is really aimed probably at production labs and studios that are doing a lot of printing. This is going to offer a very fast turnaround time or more prints out of a given 8-hour shift. So for a typical studio or wedding and portrait photographer, we also have two other 44-inch class products that probably work well for them as well.
Right, and so in terms of printing, you can print what kind of paper?
I think I'd kind of introduce you to Jeff Smith, our media manager, but we have a whole host of fine art, kind of matte medias, photo type medias, canvas, traditional matte, specialty papers where you can back mount for acrylic face mounting. So just about anything you want to print on. One of the beauties of an aqueous inkjet printer
right.
is its flexibility in media.
Right. Yeah, it looks, this is, you said brand new, huh?
brand new, the Surecolor P10000. This is actually an engineering sample. I hope to be shipping this right around the end of April, so still about 2 months away. But looking good, looking really good right now.
And then it has how many inks? 10?
This is a 10-color system, so it's got the primary cyan, magenta, yellow, light cyan, light magenta, four levels of black, okay, and then matte black and photo black are real-time in the system. So.
That's why I ask you about the black and white, because most issues with color printers is that they can't print black and white well.
Right.
But this obviously...
Yeah, our advanced screening technology for the black and white print mode leverages those four color blacks to give great neutrality, and I've got some samples, along with the ability to tone it. So if we get up...
That's a sample, yeah.
So let's look at a sample. This is a... obviously, this is not just a straight black and white print, but this is a colored print. But with the four level blacks in the Surecolor P10000, I get great neutrality through all the tonal ranges, yet phenomenal color.
This is a place I recognize. This is the New York City Public Library, by the way. So,
and on the
Surecolor, great job.
And on the Surecolor P10000, this is equivalent to about a 16 by 20 print, and this is done in 60 seconds.
Okay, and this was done here, this machine?
This is done here. I'm printing live at the show.
Okay. Yep. All right. Anything else you want to add before we move on?
I think just the statement that all the technology and things that we try to deliver at the high end benefit through our entire class of products. So the UltraChrome Pro ink technology in this is based on the same UltraChrome HD ink technology that's found in the Surecolor P600, the 13-inch desktop printer.
Oh, great. Thank you, Larry, very much for your help and an overview of Epson's new product.